Hello and welcome back to another Portworx demo. I am Ryan Wallner. This demo is going to be on PX security, specifically on using OIDC compliant OpenID Connect roles, users, groups, providers to interact with Portworx. So the first thing I'm going to do is dive into a small Portworx cluster here. I'm on node 1, and the first thing I'll try to do is show you the status. Status is operational. That's great. We have a working Portworx cluster. Now I want to interact with it. And I'll do a list volumes. And you can see I get an unauthorized user error here. And this is expected, right? Because I haven't done anything with our security features yet. I can try to create a volume. Same thing. I'm unauthorized to do so. So with Portworx security, we're going to have to configure the system to allow a user. In this case, I want to be an admin to interact with the system. One thing we can do is configure context. Contexts are things that we create in order to interact with Portworx. And if we list them, there's no context and tokens registered with our system yet, as expected. So I'm using Okta, Auth0, KeyCloak. They all work for this kind of thing, and they integrate with LDAP and Active Directory and those kind of things. So if you can see here, I have a Portworx application and a few users, one of which is myself. Here, and I have a profile, some groups associated, and this is what matters here is I'm part of the admin and system admin group. Those are recognized by Portworx at this point, and you can create custom ones as well. But here I'm just going to show you that I'm an actual user in that system, and I need to grab a token. So with Okta, you can request this URL showing that it's an OpenID token. And if I pop this into a browser here, what I actually get is the ID token back. And that token contains all of the information that I need to interact with Portworx at this point. So if I take that token and go back to our Portworx cluster, I can create a context with my name. It can be anything that you want it to be, but I'm just going to identify it as my email. And pass the token in, big old long string. After that's created, I'm now able to interact with the system, but for a little more detail, we can list the context, show it's my current context that I've chosen to use, the only one, so it chooses that automatically. And if I dig in here for this demo, I want to show you what's inside the token itself. So if we copy that token and go to jwt.io and show its contents, you can see that I have roles and groups, system admin and admin respectively, that allow me to interact with the system. So now I can go ahead and try to create a volume again. And I'm now an authorized user to do so. So I can create that volume and list the volumes. And there we go. So, I mean, this is a basic usage of Portworx security, but at its finest, we can see that it allows us to control access to the different volume and snapshot types of objects that Portworx and our storage layer inside Kubernetes interacts with. Until next time, thanks for joining.